Hi everyone and welcome. In this video I will talk about text rendering and how I managed to implement it efficiently. At first, I rendered a yellow rectangle on the screen. To do that, I've created a new UI shader which has a projection matrix as uniform. Then I've calculated an orthographic projection matrix like this. Then I've made it possible to assign a texture on that rectangle by adding a texture that I can sample from to the shader. To render a text instead of rectangles, I had to create a way of loading text and glyphs information. Free type library can be used. It's popular and has great functionality, but I decided to use STB true type library because it's very simple and easy to use. Let me now show you what font information usually contains. Imagine you have two letters on our baseline where we will put characters. Font information can tell you how tall at maximum it's above the baseline, which is called ascender, and under, which is called descender, as well as how much you can move when you go to the next line, a line gap. Let's say we want to print text from here. For each glyph that we want to print, we can extract its bitmap width and height, offset to a point from where you can start drawing this bitmap, and an advanced offset which you can use to get at position of the next character. We can also extract kerning, which is basically just an additional advanced offset for special pairs of symbols. Let's say we have A and W letters. Offset between them looks like this. But what we can do is that we can decrease this offset a little bit by some small amount. And this amount is called kerning. So I linked the STB TrueType library to my project and loaded the font information as well as information for each ASCII glyph. Then, by replacing the rectangle with a bitmap in the shader, I was able to see glyphs bitmaps on the screen. With the help of font information that we've loaded, I printed a line of text and then scaled it with the flow of time. Everything seems fine, but text rendering with this approach is actually very, very slow. There are two reasons for this. First, for each glyph we rebind a texture, and second, for each glyph we rebind a vertex array object. And they are very expensive for us. These bindings require OpenGL context to change for each glyph. And that's the reason of why we are slow. To fix the first problem, we can create a big texture that will hold our glyph bitmaps. That big texture is usually called texture atlas, and make glyphs remember their UVs in that atlas. That way we will have only one texture bind for all geometry. By doing that, the speed increased by 2 times on average. We can fix the second problem next way. When we need to push glyph to render, we will append this glyph geometry to a buffer. And then, at the end of the frame when all glyphs are pushed, we generate a vertex array object, bind it, apply texture from texture atlas, and render only once. After a few hours of debugging shader and application issues, I fixed the problem and speed increased by 5 times more. However, it still seemed to me that the speed was very small, and I was right. By removing std vector pushback calls, I've increased my speed 3 times more. This method of rendering geometry, when you build a buffer of vertices and then render it only once, is called batching. And it's a good way to optimize rendering. We've increased speed by 30 times so far. Very cool. I spent some time extending the shader, and I got 3D text rendered in the world. After fixing a few of bugs, I got something like this. You can visit my Twitch channel to see the live development process of the engine. You can ask questions or just say hi. Thanks a lot to my Patreon supporters, 1097x and Despera. You helped me to create these videos and make creation of these videos possible. Please hit like if you like this video and subscribe if you want to see more. I hope to see you in the next episodes and that you enjoyed this one. Until then, thanks for watching and goodbye.